Hello everybody, I am Welsh12 and I am playing Minecraft. No, I'm not. Oh man, I just fucked up big there. I am playing Don't Starve. Now, I've played this game before, but the longest I've ever made it to is like day 15. I'm gonna start a new world and all like that. I'm just gonna play Wilson because I think that guy's awesome. I've unlocked some of the art characters, but I like him the most because the beard he grows, it looks awesome. Like, I think it's an awesome looking beard. There we go. I'm really wondering who this is. Like, is this supposed to be his father or some just random guy who shows up? Because they kind of have a weird similar look to him, so I'm assuming it's his father. But yeah, it could not be. It could just be some stranger that's caring for me. I feel so loved. Alright, like I had said before, I played this game before. Farthest I've ever made, day 15. That's so amazing, isn't it? It's like nobody else has ever made it to day 15. Yeah, right. Don't know why I just picked up that flower. Eh. Oh well. Alright. My goal right now is to collect up some supplies, possibly find a base, and don't die. You know what I find is, it game's called Don't Starve, but more likely you're gonna be mauled by a wild animal than starve or something like that. I just find it's that weird thing. Now, in most of my other worlds, I've created probably like maybe two or three other ones and I've died. No, probably like four or five. Well, died because I suck. And the reason I think I died the most was because of the tree guardian. First time he showed up, I had no clue. I didn't know he was going to attack me. He just started walking towards me, and I was like, what the hell? And bam, he just starts hits me like three times, and I die. Hate that guy. I'm going to kill him at one point. Probably not, because I'm never going to make it that far, I bet you. Now, one of the things I want to try to do in this game, like while I'm doing these videos, is make it to day 100. Like, if I make it that far, that'll be awesome for me. Like, that'll be amazing. But the odds are is I'm probably gonna fail, and you guys are all gonna probably laugh at me thinking, wow, this guy sucks. Well, I won't care. Like, bring it on, say whatever you want, I don't care. Nope. You know what I found really strange with this guy? Like, Wilson? Is when you're chopping down a tree, he taps his feet along to the beat. So do, 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 tap, 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 tap. I kind of think Wilson is the best. I don't know if I'm actually pronouncing his name right. I believe I am. Pretty sure I am. If I'm wrong, someone correct me because I feel like a real idiot. But I find, like, he doesn't really have any special abilities except for he can grow that beard. And you can make something out of his beard hairs at one point when you shave them off. But I just find, like, he's the best because he's, like, the first character you started out, the original. So I find usually, like, the original things with anything like that, like original of something, is like the best. Because once you like make copies and make other ones, I'm not saying the other characters are bad, those guys are really cool too. Like Willow, I think, yeah, that's one of the names of like the character after Wilson. She's immune to fire, and when it gets dark out, she like starts fires automatically. So, I think that's like, that's really cool. And then is there that mighty guy afterwards? I don't remember what he was called. But he's got like more hunger and more health, and he hits harder, so he does like more damage. Oh, here's one of those, crap, what are they called again? I don't remember what they're called again, but they're one of these little ritual things that I found them before, and when you activate it, if you die, you get like a second chance, which is pretty awesome, because usually in this game, you die automatically unless you have something else. Like, there's something you can build that if you die, you get like a second chance. But those things, if you don't, like, these are good for, like, you're starting out, and you don't really know how to play the game, and you're trying to get, like, at least used to it, you just, if you can find one of those, you activate it, and say, I ran to the tree guardian again, this is me, you know, if he kills me, that thing will revive me, but it only revives you, like, 50 health, like, 50 hunger, and, like, 100 sanity, so, like, unless you're really in, like, unless you can get everything back to normal quick, you're kind of like screwed. So you want to usually stay close enough to those things that if you die, you can get back to your base quick. Because if you don't, you usually get screwed and then you're trying to survive a night or two with like nothing again. Alright, day one isn't just about over, but it's almost night, so in a minute I have to light a fire. You know what I've always wondered about Wilson? Is every 5 days, like, his beard will grow. And, oh shit. And what the thing I wonder the most about that is how far will it grow? Because I know, like, the first one, you kind of get just, like, a bit of scruff and like that. Second one, it grows a bit longer. And then I'm never gotten farther than that. I think it was, like, it was day 15, I believe, and, like, after like day 15, when you hit day 16, I believe it is, it would have grown again. Or maybe what I had it to was as far as it'll go. But I was gonna see, but then I died because I was an idiot and I used the boomerang. And I didn't know you had to, when you threw it, you had to catch it or it would hurt you. Which I think is a little bit like, it's cool, but it's kind of a little silly. But I understand, like, oh my god, I was hoping that other big tree there wasn't going to turn into the tree guardian and kill me. You know what, I think when you play this game, is there should be like a certain point when only the tree guardian will show up. Like after that, the tree guardian can show up at any time. But like, it shouldn't show up like within like the first 2 or 3 days. Like for some people, like me, that happened a couple times. One world, day 3, like that was my second world. Chop down a bunch of trees and bam, just gets right out of the ground, just kills me. Yeah, so probably around at the end of day 3 I will probably end this video, because I do have some other things to do and I'm getting a bit tired. Gonna pick a couple flowers in just a second and eat something to get my sanity back up and my hunger. Cause I don't like to let those two get too low, cause then it's really hard to get them back up sometimes if you get like stuck in somewhere. I like all the carrots that grow around. They're really useful. Oh yeah, and the seeds. I usually save my seeds for later because at one point you can build these little farms and stuff. And the farms are actually quite useful. Actually, I'm gonna grab those. The farms are quite useful because all you need is seeds and then you can just keep replanting them. And the farms, like, never deteriorate. Oh, sweet gold. I gotta get over there. Now, if you've never played this game or watched any other, like, gameplays or, like, any other videos of this, one, that you need gold in this game. Gold is a must-have. Unlike Minecraft, you don't really need gold in Minecraft. Like, you get it, and it is useful for some things, but you don't really need it. Now, I know I can just pair this game to Minecraft. That's because I see similarities in the way you have to play the games, not the games. So, don't a bunch of people get mad at me right now because I've said, oh, this is similar to Minecraft. So, I know there's probably going to be a few people like, oh, wait, Minecraft's way better than this game. There's no way these two are, like, similar. These games are a bit similar because the concept is in both games is Minecraft, you have to find food, build shelter so that you don't die and you don't starve to death and get killed by a bunch of monsters in the night. And I find this one similar like that because it's pretty much the same thing. And yeah. Oh, there's something up here. There's even flowers. That means one of the little things, something is up there. And I'm doing good with gold. In this game, you only need gold for so much for, like, science. Then after you build all the machines that you need, you will need gold for. All you need gold for is afterwards is, like, you can build gold, a pickaxe, a shovel, and like an axe. And I find those are really useful because these things don't really last that long, and the gold things last way longer. Like, I'm not gonna say, I'm probably gonna say like 4 or 5 times longer. And it's really awesome about that, like, because you don't need to build as many tools or carry flint around with you all the time. Because usually when I'm starting out, I always have, like, flint and, like, sticks on me in case I ever need, like, tools. Because if you don't have them, then you kind of get screwed. Because I know something's going to happen if I don't have them. Now, I remember seeing gold, I swear, yeah, here we go. And if you can't see, the reason I know there's gold in these things is because the little, like, they're bigger, they're darker, and they got little, like, thin strips in them. Alright, day 2 is getting close to being done. There's only like a little bit longer. Oh geez, the axe I picked up was crap. Oh wait, no. That was I think an axe I had. Yeah, because there's another axe with 100%. Like see, like with a flint axe, like each hit you do, you lose percentage. Like with the gold axe, it's like 4 or 5 hits before you lose even 1%. So I think that's like one of the best features of a gold axe. And like pickaxe, it's the same when you're doing with a pickaxe. Like 1 or 2. With a flint pickaxe, every hit like takes up 3% of it. So like, you can only get like about 30 hits out of one of them, or like 33 hits and then they break. The gold pickaxe, it's like 4 or 5 times longer. It's like 4 or 5 hits. Then you lose a percent, and that's like... Oh, shit. Ooh, just in time. Oh, I'm getting hungry. My sanity's okay. I seem to get a good supply of everything. Anyway. Oh, tough enough to handle the most intense experience. Gonna make that a little bit bigger, so hopefully it'll last the night. Oh, there, day 3 has started. Sweet. Happy right now because I haven't screwed anything up or killed myself, and I haven't done anything to kill myself. I haven't woken the tree guardian. Oh, more gold. And if you haven't played this game or you don't really know anything about it, like you've never watched or you've only like watched one other person, you haven't seen too far into the game. The reason why I haven't made any gold tools yet, even though I'm bragging about how good they are, is because you need to build the science machine, and then I believe the alchemy engine, and then you can build, like, gold tools. And, like, what I was saying is, if you look at my pickaxe right now, like, 1 second, let me just grab this stuff, and then I'll tell you. If you're looking at my pickaxe right now, Now watch when I hit this thing. Drops 3% every time I hit. And with an axe it drops it drops 1% for every hit. I'll drop that for a second. I need to drop something. Shit, what can I drop? I want gold, but I'll eat these berries. I know it's kinda stupid. I know it seems a little stupid to eat all your food when you don't need to eat it, but that's because I find the gold is a bit more important because you need gold for like almost every invention I think you make, or like every invention you make, and then after that you don't need gold anymore except the gold tools, and they're like way, like I've been saying, they're like way, way, way better. If you haven't played this game, or you are, like, I think, if you're thinking about getting this game, I suggest you get it, because I know it only can look so good, but when you're playing this, you'll like it, and you kind of like the kind of game where you gotta survive and build things and stuff like that to survive, you will probably do enjoy this game. If you like Minecraft, you will possibly like this. I don't know. Because I do like Minecraft, I have, and I play it sometimes. I haven't played too much recently because I've been busy. But I've been playing this recently because it is quite fun. But if you're thinking about getting it, I say you should get it because you can get it on Steam. I think Steam's the only place you can get it. And it's only like 15 bucks, and if you want to wait a little bit, it'll go on sale. And that's the one... the greatest thing I find about Steam is things will go on sale. It's the best thing ever. So yeah, you can just buy this game. It's only like 15 bucks. That's what I bought it for, because I was thinking, man, this game looks really good to me. And even if it was, oh look, here's some good stuff. Even if it was a little bit more or something like that, or it would go on sale for less, I still enjoy it. I don't mind. Now that I have it, I really don't even care that I paid 50 bucks for it, because I love it so much. Oh crap, that bird was loud. I'm gonna stick to the road, it's quicker. Run, little man, run! Yeah, so I'm gonna end this at like the end of day 3, so it's almost over. Holy shit, there's a lot of forest here. I have the urge to burn it right now. Oh, yep, he's right. Holy crap, how far does this go? Oh, am I in the pig's village? Oh yeah, I am. Oh, here's the pig king. Oh, there's spiders. Oh wait, no. Kill him. Oh shit, shit. Crap, that was not a smart thing to do. What the hell? Crap, like why is there so many of those things? Screw that, I'm getting away. Like what the hell? Oh, crap, there's more there. Crap, I need a way out of here quick. Why is there such, like I've never seen a forest this dense. Like, this is really cool. Oh crap, my sanity's getting low. I'm starting to see things. I'm starting to trip out. There's another one. I wish I could go into pig houses. Like, I think that'd be really cool. Like, you could have a little house you could run into. Seriously, there? I'm gonna kill him. Beat you down, good old fashioned beat down of a spider. Yeah, I'm just gonna hide over here for now to the side. Next video, I'm gonna try to find a way out of here, probably head back up where I was. So, yeah. I'm gonna take this little miner's hat thing off, because it'll. The more I wear it, the more it'll use it up. Oh, wait, no, shit, no, my bad. And I want to keep that in case I do need it. But third day is almost over, so I'm going to say thank you to everybody who's watched my video. And can you give it a quick like for me to help me get started? And like maybe subscribe to my videos, because I'm hoping to get some more up soon. I'm going to try to do my best and really entertain you guys. If there's something I can do, like, if there's something you want me to do to make this more entertaining for you, can you write it down in the comments? And if I can make it more entertaining, I will try to. Because I really want to, like, make this fun for you people to watch. Oh crap, there's another one. Huh, he just ate his buddy. Cannibalism. Cannibal. Jeez, that's stupid, but, oh crap. He's coming for me. Get him. But you know that we're going to come for that. Drop that over here. And, yeah, so thanks to everybody. Again, thank to everybody who watches this video for me. And, oh, crap, there's another one. Go, little buddy. Kill him now. Oh, come on. Why don't you just give me silk? I need silk for later on, and I can use that. But thanks, everybody, and See ya.